Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Welcome to worship on a beautiful Sunday morning. Humidity's gone, nice and cool outside. For those of you who appreciated the weather this past week, I'm sure you didn't appreciate the storms. A lot of people were without power, so prayers to all those folks that didn't have power for a few days that they have power restored and can someone get back to normal. But we thank God for this beautiful day that we have today. Just a reminder, today is Sunday, August 1st. It's Communion Sunday, so if you haven't picked up your elements, they are out there at the table. If you would please pick those up, and then we'll be at Communion, you'll have those available. We'll begin worship this morning. Are there any other announcements that need to be brought forward at this time? Okay. We will begin with our call to worship. As one body of Christ,
we have unity and love.
Speak truth to us this day, O God. Speak truth to the most inward parts of our hearts and minds, that we might speak your truth in love, and that you might speak your truth to us each and every day. In your holy name we pray.
Amen.
And join me in our prayer of confession. Gracious God, we want to live as people worthy of your call. Help us to recognize your gifts and blessings, that we may live up to our calling and bless others with our words and our lives. When we fall short, have mercy on us. When we don't know our mistakes, speak truth to us with your loving guidance. Create a new heart within us, a heart full of love and gratitude. Nourish us with the grace of your presence, we may live as people worthy of your call. Amen. And now hear these words of assurance. In Christ's grace, our hearts are cleansed and our lives are made whole. In Christ's grace, we are forgiven and loved for life.
Spirit.
just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, our Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive, and he gave gifts to his people. When it says he ascended, what does it mean but that he has also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the same one who ascended far above the heavens, so that he might fill all things. The gifts he gave were some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers. We equip saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of God, our knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure, to the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed and thrown and blown about every wind of doctrine by people's trickery, by their craftiness or deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body joined and knit together by every ligament which is equipped, as each part working properly, promotes the body's growth and building itself up in love. The gospel this morning is from John chapter 6. So when the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into the boat and went to Capernaum looking for Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which is the Son of Man will give you. For it is him that God the Father has set a seal. Then they said to him, What must we do to perform the works of God? Jesus answered, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent." So they say to him, "What sign are you giving to us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written. He gave them bread from heaven to eat." Then Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty."
Israelites complained against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. The Israelites said to them, "If only we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. For you have brought us out into this wilderness to kill us with this whole assembly with hunger." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I'm going to rain bread from heaven for you. And each day the people shall go out and gather enough for that day. In that way I will test them, whether they will follow my instruction or not." Then Moses said to Aaron, "Say to the whole congregation of the Israelites, 'Draw near to the Lord, for he has heard your complaining.'" And as Aaron spoke to the whole congregation of the Israelites, they looked toward the wilderness. And the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, "I have heard the complaining of the Israelites. Say to them, 'At twilight you shall eat, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread. Then you shall know that I am the Lord your God.' In the evening, quails came and covered up the camp. And in the morning, there was a layer of dew around the camp. When the layer of dew lifted, there on the surface of the wilderness was a fine flaky substance, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said to one another, 'What is it?' Moses said to them, "It is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat."
Thank you. before, we were eating and everything was fine, and look at us now.
Grumbling. When we read about the Israelites, and God gives them a gift, is it what they expected? Probably not. Manna, if you want to pronounce it that way, rains down from heaven, enough for the day. In the morning. The word literally means, what is it? What is it? Just like a gift. What is it? What's inside this box? What have we to open? They grumble and complain, and God listens. God gives grace and gifts of manna and quail, enough so that everyone has their fill. What gifts is God pouring out on us individually and collectively far beyond walls of your church building? Now let's go back to that question. What gifts did we receive during the pandemic, the ongoing pandemic? What gifts are we receiving? Time to be with ourselves and our thoughts, time to be with God, time to slow down, time to reflect. What other gifts might we have been receiving?
Gratitude.
Gratitude, yes, for all that God provides. We are healthy. Gratitude that we have a God who does not ever leave us. A God that gives even when we grumble. And we grumble. Maybe when you heard the question, what was the gift of the last 16 months? You thought, nothing. It was miserable. I couldn't do this, I couldn't flour in the water turned into a sourdough starter. His friend had become a baker. It's a hobby. So he's got this jar of sourdough starter, and maybe you've been a recipient of a jar of that. It's fermented flour and water, and then you have to feed it, and you have to care for it, and it multiplies, and you have to bake with it, or pass it on to someone else. So this was a gift that was going to keep on giving. And a memory, a reminder of his friend. A way that he could live out his grief and share a gift with others. And wouldn't you know, his wife threw it out. The thing he had is now gone. What do you do? Do you relate? I think we all relate a little bit to this. When we were thrust into a different type of worship and a different way of life, we grieved the things. But God, before this happened, but God, before we had all that we wanted and how we wanted it. Remember, God kicks butts. God says, I am here, and I am providing for you. The gift may look different, and there is a gift in a restarter. While the sourdough starter may have been thrown out in the trash, all was not lost. Except for about a year ago, my father was seriously hurt. So when we think about the gift we have in each other, in this place, in this body of Christ, how we receive it, the ways and means God uses to give us those gifts, may surprise us. We may develop new gifts in a restart. We might think we're ramping back up again. That's a beautiful thing about God. We can restart after restart after restart. God comes out and meets us exactly where we are, whatever that wilderness looks like, with grace, with generosity, giving us every bit of strength we need to move forward, every gift equipping us to do God's work in the world. So we have a gift. Enough for today, enough for tomorrow, enough for the future that we have in Christ. Even when God has to kick our butts again. Amen.
Thank you.
Holy and mighty God, we come to you today with a spirit of gratitude for your generosity, for your lavish gifts, for the abundance in which we live. Help us to recognize the ways you are at work in our wilderness. How you are providing and surprising us with your grace. Even when we grumble, even when we ask, "What is this, God?" I ask you for that. Help us to trust that you are providing for our every need. Encourage us. Empower communities to lead countries, to lead cities. Embolden us in our witness. This is your church. You send us out to share the good news. Direct us through every wilderness, to share your light, your love, and your peace. Be with all who grieve this day. When feeling that all is lost, and pain creeps in, bring comfort. Bring shelter. Bring peace. Thank you, God, for the gift that we have in you, for the gift of Jesus. Thank you for the gift that we have in each other. You know our every need. You provide for our every need. You know every fiber of our being. We trust you, God, to meet us where we are with grace and love. For that we are ever grateful. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and power, and glory forever. Amen. We continue with our service of Holy Communion as our elders. God, we thank you for this gift that we have, the bread of life, that nourishes us and sustains us. In the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." We take and eat. Again, at the supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for forgiveness of sin. Do this
into the world. We share the unity and love we have found here, that others may touch the presence of